Yo, we out here, you know. Got the homeboy KO.
What up, bro?
Yes, indeed.
Yes, yes indeed. Sir. 1,000.
Hey, man. Welcome back. Welcome back, you know.
Yeah.
Brighter day. It's a new day.
You know? Definitely, definitely.
A whole lot of things done changed, you know, in your camp.
Yeah, yeah.
I saw the last post you had. Not the last post you had on the gram. It was just talking about how you tired of everybody like aiming at you. You're tired of everybody blaming you.
Yeah.
And you're just going back and you're going back and you keep retweeting people who keep on saying when's the music coming.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I mean, what is it though? I mean, what's happening from KO's perspective right now?
Yeah. I mean, obviously a lot has happened, you know, but it's from an outside eye looking in, you know, there might be a bit of concern or like, you know, maybe people might get worried, especially those that are rooting for me. But a lot of positive has just transpired, you know, ever since, let's say, since that post.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, because that day I was just like feeling like super just frustrated with everything that was happening. I mean, I've been had music this whole time, you know, but you know, I'm the kind of person who before shit gets out there, I prefer to just like play to some of the folks whose opinions I value. And that day was literally my second go around with those folks, you know. And they said, you know, when I played them the second batch, and it was still saying, yeah, I mean, it's good, but it's not what you're supposed to be doing right now, you know.
Yeah.
So it kind of like, you know, I got in my feelings for a little bit, you know. I mean, I hardly do, you feel me?
Yeah.
Because I've always been just that guy, whatever I touch goes, you know.
Yeah.
And when they came at me like that, because it wasn't them trying to crush me or anything, you know, that's why I go to them, because they keep it 1,000 with me, you know. But sometimes you do get it, you do get to a point where even your parents, as much as they're rooting for you, they will tell you like, all right, cool, so your grades are all right, but like for you to get into law school, you're gonna have to do boom 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 boom, get these type of grades, you feel me? So it was just those type of things, you know what I mean? And I appreciate that. I appreciate everything that transpired around that process. Because literally that day when I posted that stuff, the single that is coming out now on Friday, I came up with it that day.
Yeah.
And another scotcher on the day, you feel me? So like the pain was worth, you know, enduring, because the monster that I have now like reignited within me, you know, is a result of all the pain and even outside of that, everything else that has like just been happening. I mean, I've seen people like just saying funny stuff like, you know, people thinking that it's a rap for the boy, you feel me? And, you know, I'm actually just one of those guys, having been here for all these years, I'm just one of those people that you'd be short-sighted to write me off. You understand me? And every wave that has hit the game, I've always been on top of it. And right now, and I've also been a leader, you know, in terms of like the culture and everything. So I want to do the same. I want to continue just like on that path.
Yeah.
That is what I'm here for. I've finally found what I want to do with the next project. And we ready to go, man. And like I said, the music has always been ready. Even the record that's coming out on Friday, like I said, I had it done about over a month ago, you know, and I was planning on putting it out at the end of June.
Yeah.
And I got like sort of kind of posted something, you know, hinting at a release in June, but unfortunately that couldn't happen, not because I wasn't ready, but after, you know, the whole cash time thing, you know, I had decided that I wanted to create a new platform for me to get my product out, to get my music out, you know. So there was paperwork involved. We're going back and forth with the contracts, and you know, my lawyer is a beast with it, so he wasn't really trying to budge on certain things. And then eventually, like literally today, we are good. You know, the ink is drying right now, you understand me? So Friday, we're doing it. It's the beginning of the new beginning, you know what I'm saying?
So I mean, so you said that you basically went through three rounds basically to kind of get like to get your stuff reviewed and say yo. And
actually, so funny because it was two rounds.
Yeah.
The new round, I actually didn't even bother going to those folks because I know exactly what they want.
Yeah.
And when they hear it, it's green light. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But like what I did do though, I just took it to like other people that like are in the game as well.
Yeah,
you know, that I kind of felt like I also just needed to get their input. And I mean, it was like mainly DJs and like radio people. And I got a green light from there. So I'm like, all right, cool. I know like this box has already been ticked. So I know they're going to be all right.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? When they hear the shit, they're going to be proud. You know what I mean? So, we're good to go. We're good to go.
But I also don't feel that your fans are fans, or even the people that follow you. I don't feel that they like guys who write you off, though.
Yeah,
I think your fans keep on saying, we want more.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Which is a positive,
you know what I mean? Versus a... Nah, you whack. Your friends, they said, nah, you know, you're not doing, you whack. They always go, but we expect more from you.
Yeah, of course.
You know what I mean?
And rightfully so.
Yeah.
Even the folks that that I'm talking about, they were not trashing what I was doing. Because, my nigga, if I'm coming in below what I normally do, it won't be... My fall off is still black excellence to the next guy.
That's
how fucking great I am. You understand me? It's not like, oh shit, this nigga can't make music anymore. You know what I mean? Like, I'm still, like, the shit that the guys didn't green light was not based on the fact that it wasn't great. It was great, but they, like, my nigga, you made this kind of Republic. And that's all I needed to hear. You understand me? And as a matter of fact, I went back and listened to the album. And I'm like, shit, these niggas are actually right, you know? So it's a certain bar that I set for myself, and I have my own self to blame. I can't be crying on anyone and being a crybaby about it and complaining, because it's a task that I took upon myself. And then I'm like, yo, okay, cool, so we're gonna get out there and claim the fucking throne and claim the crown. And now that we got it, I need to work even twice as hard to maintain the shit, you know? And now that's where that's the position that, you know, I found myself at. And a lot of the music that came out, let me say, more since top of last year, it was great, but it wasn't greater than what I'd done before. You know what I mean? For it to like blow people's minds away.
Yeah.
You know, so now I'm feeling like, okay, cool. So I understand exactly what pocket I need to be in, you know, and I'm finally in there and we are good to go.
So I mean, now it's just KO. Is there cash time? You know, I mean, does cash time still exist? Kanda still exists? What is it now, you know?
So I mean, this is actually the first interview where I'm unpacking, you know what I mean, all these things. And of course, because you're the homie,
yes,
you understand me?
Thank you.
It's only right that, you know, I divulge, you know, all the juice out here, you feel me? So with Cash Time, what actually happened was, I mean, my E is still an owner, Hip Hop Squad is still an owner, I'm still an owner, the entity is there, it's not gonna die. But in terms of what my E has in mind and what he's trying to execute as an artist and as a business guy, he has opted to go and explore and create his own setup, you know what I mean? His own desk where whatever business pertaining to the My E brand will be handled via that platform. So now we have a Hip Hop Scholar who is also, like, you know, a veteran in the game. You know, he's done crazy shit, he's influenced so many careers, you know what I mean, as a manager and as a label head, and he's also in a space where he wants to sort of kind of try and branch out and see who else he can help, you know what I mean, in terms of like directing and like shaping their careers. I'm also I was also in a position where I was like, all right, cool. So as much as I appreciate, you know, because my relationship with the big homie, you know, Scarlett, is always just going to be like what it is, you know, big bro, little bro, you know, and I value just like everything that we've done together, you know, it's been amazing. And whenever I need anything, I can just simply pick up the phone and be like, yo, you call me, I need your input on this, that, and the third, you know what I mean? So that door is always going to be open. So it just so happened that my partnership between me and him on some artist manager tip, you know, I kind of felt like our partnership had like run its course, you know, and we just needed to sort of kind of shake up and see what else we can do, you know what I mean, outside of each other. Probably in the future there'll still be business that we do together, but yeah, I mean, coming back to your question, Cash Time is just there as an entity because there are properties that are aligned with it, which is all the like the catalog, you know, everything that we put out, you know, is still managed by that situation, you know, it's that and Sony, so that has to be you know, open for the longest. And probably in the future, you know, when we decide to fuck around and do like an anniversary, like a 10-year anniversary, we can still revisit, you know, that whole situation and see what we can do, just like how Didi done did, you know, the Bad Boy anniversary, you understand me? So like these are things, because we dented the culture, you know, in a major way. So that's like a legacy that I wouldn't want us to lose in any way, shape or form, you know what I mean? So yeah, where I am right now, I've just set up my own imprint, which is now like solely focused on making sure that I'm all right. You know, the clothing brand that we had created as Dustin Company, myself and Tabiso, has now, I mean, we, everything that we did together, like creative, that I did creatively, I'm still gonna continue exploring it, you know, but the name has now been changed, you know what I mean, because I just wanted to like make sure that it is entirely like I have full control over it. So what you're seeing right now is actually just a sample of some of the stuff that you have coming out. I mean, people have seen this jacket, you know, I posted it a couple, I mean, it was part of the Dustin Company collection, but now I've just had to like go back in it and like change a whole lot of shit. So the imprint that is responsible for everything that I do right now, I mean, it's rightfully, it's kind of Republic. You know, that's like the new business, you know, that is just focused on the KO brand, and possibly in the future moving forward, I mean, yeah, it's also responsible for the clothes, but in the future as well, you know, in case I, you know, feel like entertaining grooming artists again, you know, it'll be on this platform.
Broadcast live.